Welcome to the Trade Secrets Podcast, the number one podcast in construction, with your hosts, Joseph Valante and me, Paul Selman. Get motivated, get inspired, and get educated. If you like what you hear, don't forget to like and subscribe.
Hi everyone, my name is Paul Selman and welcome to the Trade Mastermind Trade Secrets Podcast. Now today I'm joined by a very, very special guest and a personal friend of mine, Mr. Richard Dowling, and your business is?
MTR
Pipe Work Services. Now, Rich has been a client of Trade Mastermind for nearly a couple of years now, so we thought it would be interesting to get him on. We'll speak about exactly where he was before Trade Mastermind, where he is now and what is in store for the future, and then also everything that's happened in between. So, Rich, welcome to the podcast.
Nice to be here.
Thank you. So, just tell us a little bit about yourself, what you brought you to Trade Mastermind in the first place.
So obviously I've had my business now for about 15 years.
15 years?
Yeah. Okay. When I came to trade, I was sort of in a bit of a low spot personally.
Yeah.
The business was going okay, but I was working not stupid hours, 15 hours a day, traveling long distances.
Yeah. How long?
For about 5 years consistently,
yep.
Traveling to London, yeah, 15 hours a day.
From Birmingham, yeah. Jesus, there and back in a day.
Yeah,
you heard the hotels.
Yeah. We've been here, but then there's pubs that are
right next to the hotels. Right, okay, fair enough.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Just sort of was in a place where I'd had enough.
Yeah.
Saw Joe all over social media, and I thought, it's probably a load of shit, but basically came down here.
Yeah.
Sort of was impressed by it and sort of was a bit dubious about signing up.
Okay.
We signed up, and to be honest, the last 12 months especially, I think personally that just changed my whole mindset.
Mm-hmm.
And sort of, in all honesty, probably changed the course of my life.
Okay. Well, I mean, you pick up a mindset there, so I'll talk about that now. But I mean, I always used to, and I still do this with clients now, I ask them how they actually perceive themselves. Because that was one of the questions that one of my coaches first asked me, and he said, who are you? Who is Paul Selman? And every single time I ask that to a tradesperson, I'd say 8 times out of 10, they say, I'm a grafter. I'm a hard worker. And that's how they characterize themselves. Now, I'm not going to make the assumption here that when you were driving from Birmingham to London and London to Birmingham and back day after day after day, you probably still perceive that as hard work. I'm grafting. I'm earning my money. You know, but you've mentioned mindset shift, and I knew that I had to change that mindset to go from a grafter to a business owner and make other people who are grafters work for me. So that's how I got myself out of the pack. But I mean, how did you go about doing it? What has actually changed in those last 4 months?
I think you mentioned identity. I think from that perspective, I think I lost my identity. It was like I didn't exist anymore.
It became the business.
Yeah, I was, you know, at the time, obviously there's a lot of people who come to trade are in a different position. Obviously a lot of people are more just starting out.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas I was the opposite. I was sort of quite established, but I thought I knew what I was doing, and I was just doing everything. Do you know what I mean? I was paying everything. I was paying everybody. I was doing all the admin. I was basically the labourer. I was the site foreman. I was everything. I was the driver even in the van, because I don't know people driving me in the van. So I was even the one who was doing all the driving.
Yeah, yeah.
So you kind of become everything, and then you think you're the only person in the world that can do it, and how wrong was I?
I still remember you telling me you had 40 engineers and not a single admin staff.
Yeah. It's just how do you just, and at some point, the only people that were suffering was obviously myself, but even more importantly, my kids and my wife. I thought I was doing it for them.
Yeah.
And I was doing it for them, but they weren't getting the benefits of it. They were, we had a nice holiday and they could have night trainers, but they weren't getting any of me.
Yeah. Whereas that's,
do you know what I mean? And so, to come here, and then I didn't believe in any of the mindset stuff, or the, people take and think this and do that. And, if you can control the way your mind works. And I was like, well, fuck me, I can't. I was like, well, how does all this work? And then it's just down to putting everything in order and delegating. I couldn't delegate. I still struggle to this day, but I'm getting.
At least you recognise you're struggling.
Yeah, yeah. And obviously, from being at trade to now, I'd say I've changed more in 12 months than I've changed in the last, probably the rest of my life, honestly. I feel like I've grown massively. I'm from going to literally wanting to quit and literally do anything but what I was doing to now wanting to scale and double the size of my business, it's like, I don't even know I've got here.
Yeah.
I know that it's just, this, you know, meeting people like yourself and Joe and Chris and obviously Mike Green and all the other people that I've been lucky enough to meet, Alfie Best and stuff like that. You just, and now all the networking, like you just don't meet these kind of people in everyday life.
Wait,
I have these conversations with my mates because they don't want to hear it.
Yeah.
And that's cool. You know, their drives are different.
Yeah.
But when you haven't got those people that around you that are driven like you are and think like you are, it's just like, it's like literally pulling teeth. You know, and you get more and more frustrated and, you know, you try and convince people to think like you and act like you and be like you, and they don't want to do it.
Yeah, they don't.
You shouldn't force them to be like that because that's not how they're driven. So, but yeah, so just for me, more than anything, you know, a lot of people are, you know, scaled this and scaled that. For me, it's massively personal growth that is going to, I know, lead to like massive success.
We've started other businesses and things like that. And I just wanted to touch on the bit, because I was a very, what's the word I'm looking for? I was very skeptical about personal growth anyway when I came through this. And I think that was from being ex-military and just, you know, stiff upper lip sort of upbringing and then all this fluffy stuff from The Secret about, you know, picture it and it will become real. And it's, you know, so now I'm a very firm believer in that sort of stuff, but I wasn't to start with. And I think you do need to kind of frame it and then to be able to claim it as well,
yeah,
which is what you've done. And I've seen your progression through the last sort of 12 months and you've built other businesses as well outside the trade sort of industry. And I want to know how you've actually then, well, you've speculated on this slightly anyway, but you've kind of used the profits in that firm to buy your time back.
Yeah.
Because you do seem a lot more chilled out than you were 12 months ago as well.
Yeah.
So, I mean, how's that journey been? How have you structured other staff now to balance that? Or what have you done?
Well, I think there's been so many benefits. I mean, obviously, I've got my business partner, Tom. He's, like, very much different to me.
Okay.
And I think we were almost at the point of butting heads. And then I sort of found out that was actually an advantage because he's completely different to me. So that when I took a step back from the company, like the on-site stuff, he then took that role on.
Yeah.
I never allowed him to take that role because I was always so...
You're getting in your own way with it.
Yeah, because I was getting in my own way. Yeah, because I'm always wanting to control every situation. I'm a bit of a control freak. I sort of...
Mm-hmm.
It is part of who I am.
Okay.
And I'm kind of still that way, but I'm allowing people to do their job and allowing people to make mistakes. But in terms of, sorry, I've gone a bit roundabout with the question, but
it's all right.
So in regards to like my other businesses, it's just that's the other thing. All my other businesses now are also getting more time because they were being stifled from the fact that I was constantly wrapped up in this.
Yeah.
So like there was never any, you know, I never really paid any attention to the things I was, should have been paying attention to.
And you end up resenting it.
That's what I literally had that. I literally resented everything.
Mm.
I mean, when I was like 20, I was in like 50, 60 grand's worth of debt and I was happier than I am today.
Right.
And how that happened is, that's one of the questions I always ask the mentors. I'm like, how did that happen?
Yeah.
And it was just literally the fact that I was just taking too much on.
Yeah.
Like you know, I was overloaded. I was, you know, just overworked and it was all my fault.
Yeah.
And that was the thing what I couldn't get out of my head is I knew it was my fault, but exactly as you said, and you know, all the mentors use it is literally get the fuck out of your own way.
Yeah,
I mean, stop getting in your own way.
You start to realise that you're that bottleneck, don't you?
Yeah. Well, exactly that. I was the solution and the problem.
Yeah.
But at the time, I was the problem. And now I'm trying to be the solution.
Fantastic. So what have you got going in the future then? What's the next sort of 12 months, 5 years sort of look like for you then, mate?
Next 5 years, well, if I'm honest, I'm probably not looking at 5 years at the moment. I'm more without ever looking forward previously. Now I am starting to. I'm starting looking at the next 12 months. So I want to double my turnover. So we want to be edging up towards like 1 to 1.5 million.
Wow.
Turnover. For us, obviously, that's pretty massive because we don't have material costs with what we do.
Yeah, that's just labor, right? Yeah.
So look, you know, we are fairly good profit margins with what we do as well. But obviously I want to expand on the property. Obviously now's a good time to be getting into property because obviously the world's gone mad.
Yep.
Not that it's ever a bad time. Mm-hmm. But I think there are a few things I want to get into, but at the same time, mostly I want to stay focused on what has got me to where I am today.
Yeah.
Albeit a painful journey at times.
Mm-hmm.
It is the thing that's got me where I am. And so, yeah, the biggest thing now moving forward, if I do stay within this industry for the next 5 years, I'd like to think I'd be at more like 2 to 3 million.
Okay.
But over the next 12 months, it's 1 to 1.5. And then we'll see, obviously, whether the interest's still there. If not, then we'll potentially look to sell and obviously look into other industries.
Sounds fantastic, mate. Well, look, I mean, it sounds like you've got an absolute cracking plan there for structuring and building up this growth. And I'd like to pick up on the point you said about the pain bit, because people see the success bit and they'll see that what looks nice now on the facade, but they don't see all the stuff that goes on, and all the hard work, the pain, the grind, you know, all the problems, all the worrying that goes on in the background. That's why I always had to reach out to different mentors, whether that be in this industry, other industries, just to keep me on track long enough for me to actually see the benefits and see the success. So, well, look, mate, it's been absolutely fantastic to have you on the podcast. So if you've enjoyed that episode of the Trade Secrets podcast, then please click the link below to like and subscribe. Cool. Nice one, buddy.
Nice one.
All right, mate.
Cheers, buddy.
There you go.
Trade Secrets podcast, the number one podcast in construction, with your hosts, Joseph Valante, and me, Paul Selman. Get motivated, get inspired, and get educated. If you like what you hear, don't forget to like and subscribe.